Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how I did this look inspired by Lita Lestrange. This is totally wearable and not too costumey, and I had so much fun dressing up as her for a holiday party, so let's get started with the hair. So you can look up a 1920s hair tutorial, that's what I did. I'm not an expert on this hair, I don't really wave my hair like this all the time, or at all really, but I just curled my hair in one direction. It's just really tedious, and you wanna curl your hair in the same direction, so when you brush it out, all of the curls go in the same direction. So for the front pieces, I curled them inwards so they would frame my face really nicely and kind of do that curl in, as you can see here. And I started to pin it in an S formation. I saw it in a video and it's a little bit difficult. I have pretty thick hair, so it was hard, but it kind of worked out. And of course, you want to use a ton of hairspray to keep it in place if you're really going for that hairstyle. And then for the back, I basically put it in a bun and brushed it out as neatly as I could. Lita has her hair a little bit looser than I did it, so it wasn't exact, but I actually wore my hair down for the party, but this was just for the video because I thought I would just do it. So I pinned down any stray pieces with bobby pins so it looked nice and tidy, and then you could actually leave that front piece down, but I didn't do the hairstyle exact, so I pinned it back. Plus, I was doing my makeup after I did the hair, so you can do whatever you like, modify it however you want, but let's get started with the makeup. So since I was going to a party, I primed my face and put on my tinted moisturizer. It's a little bit more tinted than a moisturizer. I've been loving this Bare Minerals product, it's super nice. And then I just put a tiny bit underneath my eyes, not too much because I will be using concealer. And a tiny bit goes on my forehead. I don't like to put too much because the forehead is a bit browner. And then I put on my concealer around any areas I want to conceal and lightened it a tad underneath my eyes because that concealer is not light enough to brighten, and I used a Dampin Beauty Blender to blend it all out. And then of course I set everything. Pretty sure I used the Laura Mercier powder or Kat Von D, one of those. Then I contoured my face using the Tarte Pro palette and underneath my jaw just to add some definition back to my face, the usual. And the blush that I use is pretty natural. This is Sensual by Tarte. I love it. It goes with any eye look. I did my brows off camera to make it easier, but you can just do your own brow shape, whatever you got going on. It'll work. This isn't an exact tutorial. It's not a transformation. And this is the eye look that I'm going for. Very warm, kind of shimmery, a little bit smoky. And I'm just starting off with a transition color, pretty basic makeup, and then deepening up the crease with a warm brown and blending it out. And then just keep on layering the brown. That's pretty much what I did. I could have gone for these two kind of warm reddish brown with a bit of shimmer on the lid, the entire eyelid. And the center I topped with a golden color to create kind of a halo eye, but not so intense. And then I went over it with, again, a lighter gold just to gradually make it a halo eye. So for the lower lash line and lower lid, you just want to mirror what you did on the top. I didn't do the halo effect just because I wanted the whole entire lower eyelid to look sultry, to look smoky. Again, this is pretty basic makeup. It's just warm, shimmery reds, browns. And then I applied mascara, of course, and I added some freckles because Zoe Kravitz has some freckles and it looks really cute. And it does make the makeup look a bit more natural, which I really love. I just love the effect faux freckles had. I just love it. So of course I'm going to contour my nose because I love doing it, and I made my nose a bit more button-like, a little bit more cuter. And for the lips, I went over with a brownish nude color and some lip balm, and it just made it a little bit glossy. To highlight, I went in with kind of a natural highlight, nothing too stark, and this is the final look. The dress I found at Lulu's, the boots, are by Mark Fisher. You can find them at DSW. So that is it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you're having a magical day, and I will see you in the next video.